love rap music. I love rap music. I love it, but I'm tired of defending it. Because you got to defend rap music, man. Because people always go, that's not music. That's not art. That's garbage. How can you listen to that garbage? How can you listen to that trash? And in the old days, it was easy to defend rap music. It was easy to defend it on an intellectual level. You could break it down intellectually why Grandmaster Flash was art, why Run DMC was art, why Houdini was art and music. You could break it down intellectually, okay? And I love all the rappers today, but it's hard to defend this shit.
Static Selector.
This is live and direct.
Hey, what's good, y'all? This is Miz 100. This is the Hood Geniuses Podcast. This is special edition. This is the best hip-hop albums for 2017 so far. I know it's only August and, you know, well, we don't have too much longer in this year, but I got my music extract here, whatever. Well, I fucked that word up. We'll keep it moving. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. But I got... Hey, man, listen, yo. That's the Ciroc, yo. But anyway, I got my man, Kel, here. If to all the listeners, if you've been following the Hood Geniuses Podcast, we did an episode in January, I think. Was it January? December. December, we did the best of 2016 hip-hop albums. So, anytime... And I'm going to let y'all know, my man Kel, his ear is just crazy. He has a great ear for talent, great ear for music, period. It's not just hip-hop, you know what I'm saying? It's just me and him are hip-hop heads, you know what I'm saying? So, Kel, what's good, yo? Step to the mic. How you been, man?
What's going on, people? This is Kel.
Yeah. We're
chilling, getting ready.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, so how we gonna do this is we're gonna discuss the top five. Well, each individual. Kel, you know, he got his top five, and I got my top five. Hip hop albums, you know what I'm saying? And it's crazy because actually, you know, his John is kind of a little similar to mine, you know what I mean? And you know, before we start this, you know, I gotta shout out Lady T. Lady T will not be on this episode. She's still in Florida on vacation, enjoying herself as she should with her family, you know. So shout out Lady T. She will not be on this episode, but you know, stay tuned, continue to listen, and shout out to all our supporters. So now we're going to actually get into this. You want to go first, Kel, for your top five, or you want me to go first?
Go first. Shout out, Lady T.
Yeah, exactly. Lady T.
On vacay. Relaxing.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying? Like we doing right now. Ciroc 1800. You know what I'm saying? That's nice. Ciroc bottle look all special and sexy. The bottle like cream and gold and shit. You know what I'm saying? It looked like motherfucking a bunch of pimps hand delivered that shit to us or something, yo. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, we going
Summer Kalala.
Oh shit, what is it? Summer Kalada. Yo, this shit is smooth, yo. Shout out Puffy and the Ciroc boys and you know everything they do to make this thing taste lovely. Yeah, I would like a deal. You know what I'm saying? It's a Ciroc boy. You know what I'm saying?
Trying to get sponsored, bro.
Yeah, let's get that sponsorship going, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, so listen, you know what I mean? I'm gonna tell y'all right now, I'm not a fan of the Migos. Nope. I'm just not. And I know y'all love Future. Future dropped 2 albums in 1 year. Thank you. On money with that, right? You know what I'm saying? But we'll talk about that a little later, you know, because as we go on to actually, you know, discuss the state of hip-hop, what's going on, and, you know, where we think is leading to. So I'm going to state my top 5 right now, top 5 albums. I'm going to go with right now. Matter of fact, my top 5 doesn't have, it's not in no particular order. I'm just going to just let them, you know what I mean? Okay. I'm going to go with Logic, the Everybody album. I'm just reading them. I got to go with Joey Badass, the All-American Badass album. Jay-Z, the 444 album. Raekwon, the Wild. And Kendrick Lamar. Damn. You know what I'm saying? That's my top five right there. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to let Kel say his. And, you know, then we're going to get into the reason why we chose our top five. You know?
Damn, bro. Our list is basically the same almost except for one album. My top five is the Kendrick, Damn. Joey Badass. Sky Zoo. Logic and the Jay-Z album. And damn, I know our albums is the same except for one album, but we're gonna let y'all know what's going on with it.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna put it out there. When Kendrick Lamar album Damn dropped, you know, I said, damn, so it's different. And I'm gonna be honest. I was only feeling a couple of joints. The Lamar joint really had to grow on me. You know what I'm saying? It had to grow on me. What I appreciate about Kendrick Lamar is that he constantly evolves. He doesn't give you that same sound. And I had to appreciate him for that. Because a lot of artists and this, you know, hip hop artists in this day and time, they don't have no growth, you know, because they get stuck on the same sound, meaning production wise, same cadence, same content. That's boring. You know what I'm saying? It's good to be a fan of a rapper, but damn, you know, if we truly going to their concerts, paying for their merchandise and paying for their albums and this and that, like, yo, they should be growing with us. You know what I'm saying? Giving us something new and so we could be excited. You know what I'm saying? So the Kendrick Lamar album, I was like, damn, it's different. You know, he got a whole concept to it, which he always do that. You know, it's a deep thinking young brother right there. But I gotta say, the best song that I was filling off that John is Element. DNA. That's it. Damn. DNA is crazy. Fear is crazy. Duckworth. How can I forget that? You know what I'm saying? That Duckworth song. You know, they my top right there. Overall, I like the project. I do like the project. And it is one of the top albums of 2017. Even though I know the year is not over. But I'm sorry, I don't see nobody else drop. Not unless, you know, we both fans of Nas.
Absolutely.
Not unless Nas surprised the game. You know, because, you know, his brother Jungle be on Instagram. You know, he be Instagram and, you know, social media saying it's coming. It's coming. You know what I'm saying? They said Jungle said it's coming. Jungle said it's pretty much done. You know what I mean? I think they got to tweak a couple of songs because you remember DJ Khaled.
Right.
He had that song, you album know, on the joint. Not the album is done, right? Is that I'm saying
almost
it right?
Almost done.
Yeah.
Almost
done. You know, and which that track was fire. You know what I mean? Sir. You know, Nas is the GOAT in my eyes. I ain't even going to argue or debate with nobody. I'm done with that. He's always just going to be the GOAT to me. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
So, you want to say anything about, you know what I mean, some of them top albums?
My number one album was, loud enough, Joey Badass album was the best to me. And don't get me wrong, Kendrick is my favorite album. My favorite artist right now as far as the new guys. But Joey Badass delivered an excellent album, man. My top songs off of that album was For My People, Temptation and Land of the Free. Mm. I mean, he was dropping jewels all the way throughout the album. The production was on point. The bars was on point. I was totally impressed because his first album disappointed me so bad that...
Which was his debut
album. Oh, man, his debut album.
He got so much
album.
Hype right. With those mixtapes. The mixtape, 1999, the mix. Summer Nights.
Right. Damn. Right. It Waves. It was so... His mixtapes were so dope that I thought the album was just going to be something incredible. And that debut album was... It was garbage to me. Yeah, it was like dead. 2, 3, 4 songs. But he came back strong on the sophomore effort. And which to me, growth. Definitely shows growth and was the best album of the year, man, to me. I don't like the label things, 1, 2, or 3, but to me, this is the album that I listen to the most. Mm. You know, besides Kendrick, he was definitely number one, man, all the way through. Dope album.
You know what? This... Joey Badass album, you got a good point, yo, far as for being, you know, your number one album of the year, especially with the social climate, far as the politics and everything that's going on.
Definitely.
Far as everything, social issues is going on. And I hope y'all go and listen to it, or if you already listen to it again. And listen to it again. And listen to it again. Because this young man, he definitely has a future in hip hop. Because, you know, this is the epitome of what hip hop was created for. You know, to speak what's going on in your communities. You know what I mean? To get that out there.
Absolutely. The CNN of the hood.
Exactly.
And he's speaking on everything America. You know, we at a critical state right now. What's going on in America? We got a fucking president that's a troll. Like, I don't even want to get into that.
Yeah.
I don't even want to get into that, but
yeah.
Badass album all the way through, solid. I have no complaints. 10 on every level, you know? Mm. I'm super impressed with that album.
Mm. Yeah. You know, I mentioned the Kendrick Lamar John, you know.
Dope album.
Definitely dope album. But I'm going to have to say Jay-Z album 444 is going to end up, it's going to end up being the best album of the year. I have to say it.
Probably.
You know
so.
What I'm saying? And you know what's crazy? As much as me and you both like Joey Badass, and you know he deserves the accolades, but he's not going to get it because he's a young boy.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
He's
pretty much still fresh to the game. He's not popular. You know, and I hate that. You know, me and you music guys.
Right.
We can hear some boy down the block that will get a sight off his music and be like, yo, this nigga next to blow, his shit is fire. It's better than this person. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because we music guys, we just taking in the music. It's you know, it's touching our soul. Whereas though a lot of people, they fall into this popularity stuff. And, you know, Jay-Z really raised a lot of you jokers out there. The only, I don't even know if this a knock, but the only, like, issue I got far as Jay-Z, the album that he released, he could have been released it. You know
Absolutely.
What I'm saying? And I just feel like, as a grown man, Jay-Z is the man, you know? He definitely matured. But then there's Jay-Z, the artist. The Jay-Z, the artist, his growth was stunning.
Let me tell you one thing. It is Jay-Z, the hustler, and it's Jay-Z, the artist.
Mm.
Jay-Z, the hustler, not going to put out that think music because he feel like people not going to respond to it. So Jay-Z, the artist, had to put that out. You know what I mean? And make you think. He said, fuck it, Jay-Z, what, like 47 now? 48?
Mm-hmm.
You can't bullshit no more. It's only so long that you can bullshit. He said, fuck it, I'm just going to put out the album that epitomized my whole life, what's going on currently. Because he going to always give you the money, the clothes, and the bullshit. But this time, he gave you real life. And the young boys is upset about it, man. The young boys upset about it.
They upset about Jay dropping jewels?
Upset, bro.
Well, you know what I say about them. Just put the ER on them. You know what I'm saying? Put the ER on them, yo. Nigger. You know what I'm saying? But I ain't gonna go there. But first, my favorite tracks on the 444 album, I gotta go with, man, and like at least every other morning, I gotta listen to Family Feud. Absolutely. I mean, that song right there, like, listen, not to get all philosophical on y'all, but I'm telling you what that song does to me. It touches my soul on another level. Like, I be in the car going crazy, yo. You know, the stuff that he's saying and the way he hitting the beat, and it's just his timing is just so on point of everything he's saying that song, and the beat just, it's just crazy. You know what I mean? That's the Family Feud joint. The story of OJ.
Absolutely.
That's my fave on that joint. Then I gotta go with the Marcy Me joint. Oh man, his bars on Marcy Me, how he slow up his flow, then speed it up, then slow up his flow. Yo, crazy. You know what I'm saying? And then I gotta go with the joint Smile. Where he had his mom on at the end of the joint saying the poetry. Then he actually released some real personal stuff about his mom being gay, and he had to deal with it personally. And then he actually pretty much he summed it up like, that's my mom. I don't care who she love. You feel what I'm saying? Absolutely. All in all, that's some real deep stuff to take in. You know what I'm saying? You gotta think about yourself in them kind of situations. Put yourself in them shoes. You know, are you going to, you know, if you got issues about gay people, are you going to hate your mom if your mom or father ended up gay? You know what I'm saying? It's a real touchy thing.
That's real
touchy. But I like how Jay flipped it in the song. You know what I'm saying? So that's dope. I like the first song, Kill Jay-Z. You know, absolutely. He's self-reflecting and pretty much he emptied himself out. Pretty much it's like he emptied his insides out, and he's assassinating his insides or something like that. You know what I mean? That's an ill concept, you know. But
I'm gonna tell you, my favorite song on the album is 444. Basically, apologizing to the wifey. You know what I'm saying? Like, now dig this. You got the baddest chick in the world, and you still step out. So how other regular females feel about Jay stepping out on Beyonce? You know what I'm saying? So ladies, no matter what, no matter what, a brother's still going to act like an asshole. You know what I'm saying? He got the baddest chick in the game, and he still stepped out like an idiot.
Yeah,
that's like my
it don't matter if your yams is made out of gold. You know what I'm saying? If
platinum yams, yeah, it don't matter.
It don't matter, yo. If he can, you know, sip up your yams with a biscuit and gravy, that shit don't matter, yo. You know what I'm saying? Because you know what? Not like, listen, I ain't taking this on another shit, but like, we as men, and I'm not condoning this shit, but like, we visual creatures. You know what I'm saying? We're not emotional. We just not. Especially black men, I have to say. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm not a white man, so I don't know their experiences. Like, I know black men. I'm a black man. So what I'm saying is, like, we wasn't raised to show emotion. I'm not saying that's right. But, you know, we visual creatures, point blank. You know what I mean? And, you know, I'm not saying that we should always accept it, but sometimes some temptations is hard. Especially, you might turn it down, and then, you know, that chick might be at your job constantly, you know, walking past you, bouncing her cake on your back on purpose. And then next thing, you turn around on the next day, and it's not your back she's bouncing the cake on, you know, with her, you know, politely saying, excuse me. But next thing, your meat is bouncing back in her ass. You know what I'm saying? You know, but, you know, let me chill on that. But, yeah, we got to get back to the music, you know. So I'm going to go to the next album. I definitely got to talk about Logic, you know. I just feel as though this dude, you know, even though he looks Caucasian and...
Hold on. Let me stop you right there.
Yeah.
I was going to say the exact same thing.
Oh, shit.
When I see Logic, I feel like, damn, he pump faking. You know what I'm saying? But he can't help that he got that white skin tone.
Mm-hmm.
God damn, it looked crazy.
Come on, man,
what you doing, bro? Yeah. But when I hear the music, it's beautiful music. Mm. You know what I'm saying? But when I see him perform it, I get a little confused. Like, damn, if I wasn't at that age level, I'd be like, nigga, you fraud.
Yeah.
you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But we older now, yeah. So we understand that he's just going to identify that he's black, even though he looks whiter than the whitest white man. You know what I'm saying? But that's all I'm going to say. Go ahead, Mel. Yeah. I'm going to let you finish.
And to piggyback off what you're saying, I like the fact that, like you said, you looking like, damn, I'm kind of feeling funny.
That shit
but
feel funny,
with his
man.
Music, I like that he actually puts that in his music.
Absolutely.
And he literally breaks down his emotions about going through life and dealing with that. Yeah. Looking so white, but he's mixed.
Identifying black.
Yeah, and he's identifying black. And I like that he put that in his songs, man. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm going to go through his album right now. Oh, go ahead.
Travis Smalley. He had an interview with Travis Smalley. And he was trying to explain to Travis Smalley, he didn't understand why people and fans was looking at him so crazy. And Travis Smalley had to tell him, like, look, you look like a white boy. So we going to look at you like you're crazy. Even though the messages and the music that you're sending out is so beautiful and so much uplifting to the black people, you look like a white guy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So don't get mad, you know what I mean? You still doing the right thing, but goddamn, when we look at your face, we see Caucasian.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Go ahead, miss.
Yeah, I'm gonna get into the songs I'm feeling off his album. And the song called Killing Spree, his flow is crazy on there.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? I like how he flipped the comp set. One of my favorite, believe it or not, is called Anxiety. I like the female singing on the hook. She kill it. And basically, what the song Anxiety is, he actually talks about... I mean, this dude is really dope, yo. He actually talks about him experiencing an anxiety attack and him not understanding it. He didn't understand the reason why him, the individual, is having an anxiety attack. And he breaks it all down in a song. And it's so deep, man, because a lot of people, a lot of people out here is experiencing anxiety attacks. And some don't know why and all that, you know what I mean? Some people got to take medicine for that. And honestly, shit, sometimes I get anxiety about the podcast, about recording. And, you know, I got all these different guests and I got to make sure the sound quality is good. You know, listen, the simplest things can cause you to have anxiety. You know what I mean? Shit, your kids might cause you to have anxiety. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
So I thought that was really a dope song. You know, I like the song Black Spider-Man. That's, man, listen, yo, if you're a deep thinker, you're going to understand Black Spider-Man. You know what I mean? Oh, man.
That's my favorite song right there.
Yeah.
I can't even say that. Afro, whatever the fuck.
Yeah, Afro-Aryan.
Favorite song.
You know what I'm saying?
There you go.
Yeah. You know,
that's my favorite song.
He's a dope. I mean, listen, you gotta like this dude. This dude got a song with Black Thought and Chuck D on it.
How many rappers can say that they can bring together Black Thought and Chuck D?
And think about that, right? He young.
Young boy.
He young. So what he did was Chuck D from 88, 86, 88. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
You know, we old heads.
We know, nigga, bro. We know, nigga.
You know what I'm saying? So he got Chuck D from 88, you know what I'm saying?
86.
Yeah, 86, technically. You know what I'm saying? And then you got Black Thought, Roots, 90s.
Philly legend.
Hip-hop legend, pretty much.
My top
much.
Five MC Man. Of the 90s era.
Man. Lyrically, come on, yo. And he held his weight on a song with two other legends. Because he's on his way. You know what I'm saying? If he keep it up, you know what I mean? Hopefully this dude, you know, continues to have success that he's having. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
But yeah. And you know what? Logic is another artist. He always got a concept to his albums, like Kendrick Lamar.
All concept albums.
And I'm gonna tell y'all something. What I liked about this is he gave a surprise at the end of the album. It's a J. Cole. Yeah.
A little freestyle.
I don't think people know. It's like a J. Cole song that I guess he was working on. And they didn't even, you know, put it on there that J. Cole got that on there. But if you listen to the album all the way through, you're able to hear like an unfinished like J. Cole verse. You know what I mean? It's not mixed or mastered, but you hear right. J. Cole rapping. Like you said, it sounded like he was off the top with it, trying to, you know, fuck around with some shit. And it was dope. It was dope. And if you look at Logic's album cover, and you really, really look at it, J. Cole is actually in that background on the roof. You know what I'm saying? He threw him up there and shit, yo.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? All them subliminals, you know what I mean? I like that kind of stuff, yo. You know what I mean? But we can go on to the your next album that you want to talk about. Because you got an album in your list that, I mean, I fuck with it. I won't say album, but a project. You know what I'm saying? I fuck with it heavy. I just was shocked that it made your top five.
Yeah, it's my man Sky Zoo. It's an 8-track album. So I wasn't sure if it was an EP or an LP. But I'm going to put it in my top five. And he basically paying homage to all the big boys. You know what I'm saying? The Bad Boys. The Nas. He quoted a lot of Nas lyrics in his album. It's crazy. He quoted a lot of Big. You know what I mean? You know he loved Jay-Z. But he like paying homage to the top gunners of the 90s era. The Jay-Z's, the Nas, the Tupac's, you know what I'm saying? But pretty much the New York rappers. Mm-hmm. And that shit is dope. And like one of my favorite joints on there is the Bamboo. Mm-hmm. That's basically a character of Fredro Starr from the Onyx. I believe the movie is Strap.
Oh!
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
it's basically the movie Strap, where Fredro, you know what I'm saying, was selling the guns and shit.
I think
Onyx
said that was their first movie.
Yeah, that was Fredro, I believe his first movie.
Yeah.
And I mean, Fredro was raw, just straight ignorant on that joint.
Yeah, he was.
And you know what I mean? And then another one of my favorites was the 95 Bad Boys logo. Mm. You know what I'm saying? He killing that shit on there. Mm. And then he got a little sample of Mace, you know what I mean, dropping some bars on a mixtape that who was on who dropped that mixtape for the Bad Boys? Was it Clue? I think it was Clue.
It was either Clue or Flex.
I think it was Clue. You know what I'm saying? Like dropped that Bad Boy joint. And man, for all those who haven't listened, it's 8 songs, 31 minutes, Just go and listen to that shit. It's dopeness. Like, if you love that 90s hip hop era, Sky Zoo, give it to you, man. And I love Sky Zoo, man. He's a hot ass MC, man. But I don't know what's up with this. Everybody dropping their shit by themselves, man. But I can respect it, man. Like, Sky Zoo, he's a dope ass MC. He was on Duck Down. I don't know what's going on now. Let's say first generation rich. I gotta do more research.
It might be his own
shit. But Sky Zoo, dope. You know what I'm saying? Just check it out. 31 minutes of rawness. You know what I'm saying? Definitely made my top five of the year so far. You know what I'm saying? It's only 8 tracks, but it's well worth it, people. Listen to it. That shit hard. Long Money, one of my favorite ones. Short Money, one of my favorite songs. They only got an 8. So check it out. You know what I'm saying? What you think about that, Mill?
Yo. One of my faves. Favorite songs on there is Finesse. Everything.
Ooh.
Yo. In the car. In the car, yo.
Shit hard.
Yo. I'm going to tell you, yo. And you know, as far as the history I had with Sky Zoo with the past, like, I've been
tell
listening
him, tell him about it. Tell him about the history. Tell him why. Tell him why you mad, son.
Alright. Due to my past history of dealing, working for Introspect Records, you know, we had some past dealings with Sky Zoo, and one of our artists actually.
Who used, the artist, man?
Oh, Access Immortal from Brooklyn. He used to mix down Sky Zoo music. And this is like back in 2005, 2006.
Time out.
Yeah.
So Access Immortal was actually doing production also?
Oh, I never told you. Man, a lot of songs. Man, for Medina, right. We were sending to him. And it's funny, yo. A lot of people don't know that because we did pay for a lot of mixing and mastering,
right.
You know, but man, a lot of that was Access, yo.
Shout out to Access Immortal, man. Yo, we gotta get him on the show.
Yo, yeah, we do. His ear was crazy, yo. As far as production and tweaking the levels, yo, that's why people used to be like, man, what studio y'all record at? Man, Medina was recording in his bedroom, in his mom's crib, yo. You know what I'm saying? People used to be like, yo, y'all shit sound like crispy clear and all that. So we would let Access, man, we would let him do the superior mixdown, and then we would send it overseas. And they would do the mastering professionally. Okay. So it was just like top notch. You know what I'm saying?
Who was mastering overseas?
I forgot the name. I think it was called Crystal Mixing or something like that. They was like in London. I don't know. Something like that. We would actually send the whole, you know, WAV files, all them files, all that stuff. But getting back to what I was saying was, Access, not only was he, you know, coming up, building his buzz as an MC, but he was building his name up as the boy in the hood who had the best mastering skills and mixing down the work. So word got out, he in Brooklyn. So he had, man, several rappers, well known, that wow. He was mixing down their project. Well, mainly they mixtapes back then. That's why a lot of, you know, Access mixtapes sound like on the album level, yo. You know what I'm saying? And you know, White Boy Fest, they got cool, but I think, you know, White Boy Fest used to go up to Brooklyn.
So he was learning pick up shit.
Yeah, he was learning, you know what I'm saying? So that's why, I remember, used to be like, damn, Fest shit sound crazy. He learning for Access. You know what I'm saying?
We gotta get Access on the show.
Yeah, man. Yeah, definitely. We gotta get Access and Immortal on the show. You know what I'm saying? He doing his photography thing now, and then he went to school for he making video games and shit like that. You know what I mean? You know, I still follow him on social media, whatever. You know, always is a cool dude. You know, whatever. But Sky Zoo used to do the bartering thing. When we first gave Access his deal, you know, ask Desperate and like, yo, get on my album, give me a verse. And when I first heard Skyzoo, it was a song called on Access album, American Me, called Sharks and Water or something like that. Absolutely. And I was like, damn, who this boy Skyzoo? Nice. And the accent was like, oh yeah, I got songs with him and this and that. So I heard Skyzoo just like 06.
Yeah, that's
you know. So I used to hear him a lot. And then dealing with other artists connected to the record label, you know, they knew that we had some type of connection with him, so they would be like, yo, we want him, you know what I'm saying? So we reached out to him, and I, you know, this is real talk. This group we had wanted him, so there's like, damn, man, how much he gonna charge us? You know, we hit Skyzoo up, and he charged like $800 for a verse and shit, you know what I'm saying? And the group at the time was three members, so they got their money together. You know, we sent him the money. You know what I mean? It is what it is, yo. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's crazy how all this, you know, when I was in the music industry, well, I'm still in the music industry, but when I was into the record label and managing artists and all that, I was around so many people that have big names now. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was around people before they was really big, but I seen the talent. I seen they would, if they focus on their craft, they was going to get bigger. And, you know, it is what it is. You know, I don't really care for it because people like, oh, Mr. 100, he ain't nobody, he ain't Buffy, you know, he ain't fucking Charlie Mack or something, you know what I mean? Because right. I'm not a celebrity, but I was in those circles, you know what I mean? But it is what it is. But yeah, Skyzoo is definitely a dope artist, yo. His catalog is crazy. If you got Tidal, Apple, Spotify, whatever, you got a paid subscription, yo, just go on them apps, yo. Listen, take your time, listen, yo. And you know what? This is a segue to you know, we talking about these New York rappers, so supposedly, you know, underground rappers. But you know how these New York jokers be talking about, it's no more New York sound. That's shit. Not true.
It's not true.
And you know, Torre,
that's my man.
Skyzoo. It's plenty. You know what I'm saying? Shabam Sadiq.
Yes, sir.
Man, I can go on for days.
Friend of
yo.
The show.
OC.
Absolutely.
Oh, damn.
OC album was nice.
Man, you know what I'm saying? Man, you know, throw that under honorable mention. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it should be honorable mention.
Where you at?
Yeah, so, you know, as far as the Skyzoo joint, you know, that's classic. You know, I think it is, you know, classic material things. But absolutely. I wanted to get into saying, as far as with them, you know, the New York rappers, man. They saying it's not no hip hop, the New York sound or whatever, whatever. And they, you know, they so big on wanting to give so much props to the new wave. But I'm gonna get into that a little later. I want to talk about this Raekwon album that was released, The Wild. Man, he killed it. The song with CeeLo.
Absolutely.
Oh my God. Yeah, Marvin's or something like that. Yo.
Now the song Marvin was about Marvin Gaye. He basically gave you a mini documentary audio into Marvin Gaye's life in 3 minutes. But it was dope because you gotta think about it. No other rapper ever did that before.
No.
And Marvin Gaye's life was crazy because his pop was a priest, a pastor. And you know, once you go into that R&B type of style of music, the pastor father don't approve of that shit. So him and his father have a very bad relationship. And damn, it led to him killing his own son.
Yeah,
I don't think I can do that. I probably can pop my son in the ass and a leg or something, but I ain't going to kill him. You know what I'm saying? I ain't going to kill him.
Yo,
you know what I'm saying?
Yo, you said you could pop in the ass or the leg. Though,
I got two sons.
Let me find out if you like Kanan and some shit, yo. this motherfucker.
Nah, I ain't gonna kill him. Kanan killed that motherfucker. I know. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'll pop him in the leg or something, but dang. I ain't gonna take him out.
Yeah, that's. Yo, his pop was foul, yo. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
It's foul. Even though he's a pastor, preacher, yo, them dudes be having diseases of the heart, yo. They ain't Jesus-like. They ain't God-like, yo. Them dudes, man. Come on, man. I ain't gonna get on that, but, yeah, that Raekwon John is fire. Make sure y'all go listen to that, yo. From start to end, I rock with it. No doubt. That made my top five. You know, it is what it is. But is it one in your top five that we didn't talk about? I think we covered it because we had kind of the same drinks.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, we had. The only joint that you didn't have in your top five was Skazo. So we covered Kendrick, Joey, Logic, Jay-Z. But I'm going to get into my honorable mention. And one of the albums was Talib and Styles P album. Now, it was seven songs, so I didn't know whether it was a album or EP. Seven songs is usually an EP, so I'm just going to make it an album. Shit was dope. You know what I mean?
Fire.
One of my favorite joints on the album was the intro album. The intro song. You know what I mean? And that was Poets and Gangsters.
Yeah.
And they went in on that.
You think that might be the best song on there, though?
One of the best songs, because they was super tight. Lyrical on that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
It's an ill combination, though. Styles P and Talib.
You know what I'm saying? You know how the depths of what they saying and what how they MC? Styles P, my top five in the new era. I'm sorry. But,
Styles P is a monster.
He's a monster on that shit. Talib also.
Yeah, you know that. You know that, that playlist that you sent me.
Woo!
The best of Talib. Now, I'm going to tell you, I'm a fan of Talib. But when you sent me that playlist, that made me realize how dope he is. Yo, his catalog is bananas, yo.
Now, time out before you finish. Everybody would have thought Most Def would have had the better playlist.
Yeah.
Nah, Talib.
Yo.
Talib.
And if you think about it, right? Nah, I'm cool. I ain't gonna say that.
Say it, nigga. All the way 100. What you about to say, nigga?
I'm gonna say, if you think about it, because I was gonna say Talib was the one that musically worked harder. You know,
absolutely.
Most dabbed into
most
the actor.
Had to act.
Yeah.
But he was actor first before rapper.
True. Yeah. And what I was gonna flip it in comparison to Freeway and Beans.
Now what you gonna say?
I was gonna say that Beans, you know.
Say
jail
nigga.
Time, whatever. Right. But because Freeway steadily worked and worked, his music catalog actually can be either on the same as Beans or might be slightly better.
Time out. I agree with that. Freeway put out more projects
and
at a better quality.
Phony.
But Beans' songs might be stronger, but his catalog not stronger than Freeway's. I'm sorry. And Beans a better artist. So I agree with that.
Yeah. And you know, I got that Best of Beans sequel playlist too.
I got one too.
Oh, you got one?
I ain't sent it to you.
Oh, I got. Don't worry, but I already got one. I fuck with that.
Beans, one of my favorite artists, but he disappointed me so much. Man.
Yeah, man.
The jail shit fucked him.
Yeah, man. He throw the ER on him too. Y'all already know what I'm talking about. You know what I mean? But that finished your honorable mention joint.
Other album or honorable mention was David Banner's.
Okay. Now, I didn't listen to that.
The God Box.
Yeah.
What you say, nigga? You ain't listen.
I only listened to it twice.
Come on.
I got.
Now the God Box was dope. The only thing that I had a problem with was all the songs that he let us hear. He didn't replace them with new material. So I was a little disappointed in that. You know what I'm saying? He had like at least four or five songs that he let us hear a year or two before he released the whole project, and he didn't replace them. But they still dope ass songs. But
yeah,
that's all my honorable mention.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
He hyped that shit up enough.
Yeah, man. He
you
did.
Know what I'm saying?
But he traveled the world and tried to educate us on what he was talking about.
Yeah.
Dope ass album. Yeah. Strong ass bars.
Yeah, he did something different. I gotta actually listen to that album more. Definitely gotta listen to it more. Real talk. That's finish your
That finished my honorable mention.
Okay. Yeah, I got on my honorable mention joint. I have Freddie Gibbs drawn.
I like that.
You Only Live Twice.
I like that.
Which, you know, we talked about it for the episode. It's an EP. I think 8 songs.
Absolutely.
Yeah. It actually surprised me. I mean, I always look, you know, I heard him some features, but I never really listened to a Freddie Gibbs project entirely. You know what I mean? Besides maybe a mixtape or something. You know what I mean? But I'm banging with this, yo.
Hard.
You Only Live Twice. Production is crazy. Oh man, the first song is crazy. That 20 karat Jesus song.
Hard.
Amnesia. Yeah, that thing. Yeah, I remember sending that joint to you or something. Or you might have sent it to me. I'm like, man, this thing crazy, yo. Early in the morning, I'm rocking going to work. Like, damn, I gave it a second listen at lunchtime. Like, yo, yeah, this boy nice, yo. You know what I mean? I'm glad he was able to bounce back because he was facing a rape charge and all that shit.
Yeah.
Come to find out, that was BS. So now he back on his music, you know, which is
a good
thing.
You know who he dating, right?
Who he dating?
Eric Dickerson, the famous running back from L.A. Rams' daughter.
Oh, wow.
You knew that, right?
No, I don't know that. What the fuck is that? How you... Hold up, man.
He had an interview about that.
Oh, for you not to be on social media and internet all like that, yo, you'd be surprising me. You be giving me the scoop and shit. I'm like, damn, I ain't know that.
Yeah, he dating Eric Dickerson, the famous running back from the L.A. Rams. He was on an interview with the Breakfast Club. And I was like, damn, like, you know what I'm saying? That's very interesting. I know a lot of you fans don't give a fuck or whatever, but Eric Dickerson was a beast on the field. So you know he has definitely the ear of his daughter. You know what I'm saying? He's somebody in the game.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Definitely somebody. And Freddie Gibbs, a little thug ass nigga
from Gary, Indiana, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Where? Who from there?
Michael Jackson, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Crazy. Grimy. Gary, Indiana, like
place.
North Philly, yo.
And my man that I work with, this nigga do videos, you know what I mean?
What you mean
he
do videos?
He do videos. He a good photographer.
Oh, you're videographer.
Yeah. He worked with me. He my man. But he visited Gary, Indiana. And he said when he went to go see Michael Jackson home, you know what I'm saying? He was going to see his homies in Chicago. They drove him out to Gary, Indiana to see Michael Jackson home. And he said it's like projects right before, you know, the home. And he said, you know, they outside visiting. And he like, niggas like, yeah, I want to fuck your bitch. Said it real loud to get their attention. And he like, damn, you know, like, it's a project. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn, we a little, you know, far from home. So he like, shit, you know, what I'm going to do? So he ate that. You know what I mean? He disrespected. They was there with some white people and shit. So he said they had to leave with the white people so the niggas wouldn't fuck with him. He said the niggas right there looking at him like, yeah, what, nigga? What? Not even saying anything to the white folks. Fucking with all the black people that come out to see Michael Jack's house.
Hey, listen, yo. That's a foul ass story, yo. I swear I don't want to get on my Malik Shabazz, El Shabazz.
You don't want
shit,
that shit. You know they need to hear that shit, man.
Nah, I'm just leave it to the music, yo. I'm gonna leave it to the music, yo. That's a. You know, we get you on the episode. We got Lady T, Pocket of Podcast and shit. You know what I'm saying? With the fiery passion. we get you on the episode. We talking about the serious social issues like that, because that's some real foul, deep self hate bullshit right there. You know what I'm saying? And I want, while I'm on this tip, yo, shout out Cap, yo. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Kaepernick, Colin Kaepernick, yo. Shout him out majorly, yo. The brothers don't want to support you, yo. Keep doing your thing, man. You know what I'm saying? Keep shining. Do what God, not what he gave you as a talent to be on the field. Give him the spirit that he gave you, what you doing. You know what I'm saying? You got people out here really, you know, not fucking with Cap. You know what I mean? And they of color. I ain't gonna get into that. Stop right there.
And I agree with that, bro. Cap, absolutely 100% right. If the NFL don't hire Cap, fuck!
Yeah, exactly. You know what I'm saying? But I definitely gotta mention this album, Showbiz and AG, on my good honorable shit. Mention. Man, it almost made my top five till I remembered that Raekwon released the Wild. But it definitely was in my top five. I'm like, damn. Digging in the Crates crew members. Man, if I don't understand if y'all understand this 90s hip hop shit, yo. It's so many people from that great era released nice albums in this era. You could throw Jay-Z from that era. Are you from the 90s, bro? You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Raekwon, OC,
Nas,
Showbiz, AG. Listen, yo, they album is called Take It Back. And this what cracks me up when, like I said earlier, New York people keep saying that the sound ain't there. That's not true. Showbiz and AZ, Sky Zoo, Touré, they give you that New York sound. Every effort.
Every time out.
You know what I'm saying? And this Showbiz and AG album is, I mean, hard. I like the fact that it's hard. And they didn't compromise their style and sound. You know what I'm saying? Because it don't sound dated. But it's still new. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I got you. So, yeah, we're going to go into the next thing we're going to talk about.
On this album.
We're still going to talk about this album. Okay, no doubt. Yeah, so, back to what we was talking about. The Showbiz and AG album.
Dope.
This is dope. Just go cop it. Stream it. Buy it. Share it. Enjoy it. Point blank. Alright, so now we're going to get into, you know, we got to talk about this. You know, this affected me and Kel. Being big fans of Mobb Deep. You know, we got to address the death of Prodigy. And I got to say this, one of the illest, you know, lyricists. He had his own style. Sometimes the boy didn't even rhyme, but it made sense. Some of the darkest, grimy stories, the most sampled rapper to date by producers. His lyrics is the most sampled by producers to this day. You know what I'm saying? It's just crazy how this man died. You know, he was battling sickle cell for so long. You know what I mean? What's up, Kel? What's your, you know, thoughts on Prodigy's death?
Oh, man, that was, let me know if I'm too loud. That was my man. I definitely feel what he was going through. I battle sickle cell also. I know Lady T also battled that, along with her kids, her daughter, I'm sorry. And it's a definitely serious disease in the black community, which I think these crackers put into our system, but that's another story, that's another episode. But Prodigy was one of my favorite MCs. I'm You know what I'm saying? Let me know if I'm too loud, Mel.
No, you're good.
He definitely was one of my favorite MCs. Shook Ones, the infamous album, was top five albums of hip hop of all time. Production, beats, you know what I'm saying? The rhymes, everything. Prodigy was one of my favorite MCs. Like Mel said, the most sampled MC in hip hop history, also along with EPMD. That was one of my favorite rappers, man. That hurt me to the core. Like, I know I sound like a bitch, but fuck it. I shed a tear for Prodigy. He was one of my favorite MCs, man. That hurt me to the core. And finding out the way that he passed is strictly on some bullshit. Like, they wanted him to die.
You don't even
want
to mention that shit.
Yeah, I'm not even going to mention how he died, yeah. But it just sounds like they wanted him to die. Because he was he was far advanced in knowing what's going on with America. But that's all I'm going to say about that. But far as the music, he was one of my top 10, top 20 MCs, man. That was my man. I love Prodigy. Mobb Deep was my favorite group. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just going to leave it as that. That one hurted me to the core, man. That hurted me, man. And I love Prodigy. I love Mobb Deep. That's my squad. And I hate to see that Havoc still has to perform without Prodigy.
That's
like
crazy.
I don't want to see that. You know what I'm saying? And I know he has to fulfill obligation, you know, business wise, but I don't want to see that shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
that's all I'm gonna say on that one.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, I guess the best thing Havoc can do is just bring in guests to fill in for Prodigy. You know, I say the best person that he should just get Big Noid, yo. You know
what I'm saying? Noid.
Yeah, get Big Noid to fill in for Prodigy, yo. You know what I'm saying? And to fill out all, you know, the concert deals and all that. You know what I mean? But what amazed me about Prodigy's death was, I mean, all over the world, he was getting saluted.
Absolutely.
I seen a news channel. You know, they did a salute to him.
That was dope.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? They had the Shook Ones playing at the baseball stadiums. Only his verse, which is one of the most. Listen, yo, if you really know hip hop, you know Prodigy's verse on Shook Ones. That's one of the illest verses in hip-hop, period. One of the illest verses, period, yo.
I agree.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's easily, verses-wise, one of the shit top five. And I'm saying this on some dick eating because my man died. I've been saying that. You know what I'm saying? Mobb Deep is my favorite group, period. You know, if you know
Absolutely.
Me and you actually been riding in the whip with me, you know it ain't it. Listen, before you get to your destination, you in a car with me, a few Mobb Deep songs gonna come on in my rotation when it's on shuffle, yo. You know
Absolutely.
What I'm saying? Like, shit, you gonna get overdosed with some Mobb Deep sounds. You know what I mean? Yeah, you know, shout out to Prodigy and his kids, his family, you know. And remember I sent you that recently, that interview where Prodigy was getting interviewed at MIT in Boston?
Yeah.
And you see how the audience, you know, how they, you know, he was talking to, and it's crazy why he was alive. That was in 2015. No big time rap publication that on their website?
Let me tell you something.
That shit is crazy, yo. This is Prodigy from Mobb Deep, and they wanted They requested him to be there to talk to them at MIT in Boston. Now, yeah,
okay. Absolutely. It's crazy, man. Black folks, we undermine the power of our own shit. White people study us like we fucking animals. You know what I'm saying? And I don't mean to sound that cruel, but they fucking idolize us. You know what I'm saying? You would think it was vice versa, but they idolize us to the point where they love us more than they love themselves, because they hide our history so crazy. You know what I mean? That it's ridiculous. And I'm not a fucking scholar, a PhD, or any of that. But one thing I do know is white folks study us more than we study our own selves. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Talk to them, man.
Yeah, man. Yeah, I can go on about that. You know, it's a reason why they study us, why we under the microscope.
Tell
you
them
know?
Why.
The reason why is because they jealous, yo. They
why?
Jealous of our melanin. If you understand the simple things that our melanin represents, you will be jealous too. You know
tell
what I'm saying?
About that melanin.
You know,
that?
They can't even. Man, I'm gonna stop right there.
No, I gotta stop. Real quick. Just give them a breakdown. Real quick.
Listen, yo. You know what I'm saying? Basically, far as when it comes to black people, we are the founders of all this shit, yo.
Absolutely.
We are the forefathers of the forefathers.
Absolutely.
If you want to dig what I'm saying, it's always us that come through and create the fucking shit. And then what do the white man come through? They come through, study us, and say, oh, this how they did it.
And still
us. And they incorporate the shit. They say, okay, they create laws to stop us from, you know what I'm saying? They create laws and bills for us to stop us from knowing that we was the creators of our own shit.
Real rap.
You know what I'm saying? Listen, yo. I mean, you could look at somebody like Booker T. Washington.
W.E.
Du Bois.
All right, fuck it. Get back
yeah,
to the
yeah,
fuck
yeah.
it. Fuck it. Yeah, I mean, know they
yeah,
don't,
we ain't
care. They don't care about yeah, that. Get
yeah,
to the music.
Talk to the music. But, yeah, you know, Mobb Deep, Prodigy, shout out to them, yo. You know what I'm saying? I hope Prodigy, you know.
He looking down. He
yeah, he'll be looking down on all this, man. And shout out to Havoc, yo. He holding it down out there by himself. And somebody said in the interview, if you notice, Havoc haven't took off his sunglasses yet when those cameras is on, because that's
just,
his way of mourning.
He just did.
Oh, he just did?
He just did. I seen him in a few interviews. Let me know if I'm too loud. No. And he just did. But that's neither here or there. Mobb Deep, Prodigy. You niggas gotta respect Prodigy, man. Stop all that bullshit, man. What he did and what he stand for was much bigger than you sucking niggas trying to discredit his legacy. You know what I'm saying? And that's all I'm gonna say on that.
Yeah.
That's it.
And another thing that's corny, you seen that shit that was going on in Queensbridge with the mural, and they tearing it down, this and that. And then
that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I actually watched the interview where some boy from Queensbridge, I think it was Mike DeLurion, and he was talking about how that was some hood shit. You seen that, John?
Now he from down south, I believe. He is one of the Scarface number one producers. That's the white boy.
No.
Not Mike. Saying Mike DeLurion.
Yeah, there's some hood nigga from Queens.
What?
Yeah, I ain't seen you this interview. So basically, he broke down the mural situation. He was saying that it was some Negroes in Queens that was saying Prodigy doesn't deserve a mural in there because, you ready for this? You ready for the scalp?
I'm ready.
This man is dead, and they said he doesn't deserve a mural in Queensbridge because he never came back to Queensbridge and talked to certain individuals who he had beef with to squash it. So they gonna just say fuck it. He, even though this man died,
right?
He don't deserve to have a mural. All over some real coon shit, dumb nigga hood shit. So they said he don't deserve that mural. So they kept throwing paint on it.
That's crazy.
Some real hood shit. That's him. He's from Queens. He's from Queensbridge.
Oh shit.
He got songs with Prodigy and Mobb Deep, all that. Actually, Prodigy tried to put him on. You know what I'm saying? When he was doing his solo shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But look, man, look, I don't want to entertain that too much.
His name is similar to the
producer.
Producer.
I ain't know that. I only knew him from because I'm a big Mobb Deep fan. You know what I'm saying?
You know
he got songs with them and
I am
everything.
Too. I am too.
Yeah. So.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, man. Like our, like I said, our people is beyond like done, yo. You know what I'm saying? Like they letting the dumbest shit get in between. Like letting the hood shit get into this man's death, yo. You know what
I'm
saying?
And I feel some type of way about that. We gotta let bygones be bygones.
You got to. And this man not here on not here on earth no more, yo.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So before we wrap this up and everything, we're gonna give our opinions and discuss the state of hip hop, where we see it was going, our opinions of it right now, currently. You know, because I know some of y'all jokers out there probably, damn, they ain't talk about the Migos. Damn, they ain't talk about Future.
Garbage.
You know what I'm saying? Listen, well, we're going to give our opinions. And we're going to tell you our reasons why we didn't talk about the Big Sean's and the Migos.
Garbage.
And and you know, it's not that we some old niggas and we stuck in the fucking 90s. No, like, we just like good music. And before we start that, we're gonna get into the disappointments, the albums that was big disappointments. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna break down the reason why they disappointments. You know what I'm saying? And before we get into that, yo, we need to stop the dick eating, yo. Fuck this old popularity contest. Let's keep it with the music, yo. So what? Because a fucking artist on Instagram, he talking to money. That's the shit Jay-Z was talking about. So what? He talking to a stack of money. The fuck a stack of money gonna do if he got a bullet in his fucking head, yo? Because the fucking hood always watching, yo. You putting up that shit bragging, you stepping on the hood, but you don't even feel comfortable in your own hood because you done bragged so much on dumbass Instagram. You don't feel comfortable in your own shit.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? But we're gonna talk about this thing. You know what I'm saying? I know Kel, you ready. You know what I'm saying?
Let me know if I'm too loud. The first album that I'm disappointed in is Meek Mill's Wins and Losses. A lot of people said he showed growth and this and that and the other. I'm disappointed. I didn't see no growth. The flow is the same. The beats are the same. Everything is the same. If you put Meek, all of his albums together and just play them all at one time, it sounds like the same fucking year, the same album, and the same producers. So stop telling me that. And don't get me wrong. I love Meek. He from my son block. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not hating on him. I love that he went in. That's my nigga. He represent Philly and all of that. But I'm a little disappointed in the wins and losses. He didn't show enough growth to me. You know what I'm saying? That's the number one album that I feel disappointed in. Let him know, Miz 100.
Listen, I have to agree with Kel right here. You feel what I'm saying? And I'm going to state my opinion why I agree. I agree because Meek, he did mature as a man. And what I seen that in his interviews, he got on them interviews and, you know, stated that he did a lot of dumb shit because he actually was on that lean shit. And he stated that you know, looking at himself and listening to himself while he was on the lean stuff was a bad move, bad for business, bad for his brand, period. I salute that. I definitely salute that. He gave some great interviews while promoting this album. And actually, I was excited. I was excited to listen to the album. It came out. I'm on track 3. I'm on track 4. I'm on track 5. I said I'm fucking bored, yo. I'm bored because I could tell he didn't download. He just didn't download that dictionary app yet.
Dang.
You gotta step the vocabulary game up, Meek. I know you ain't got time to read books, but you should. But you just gotta step that vocab game up, yo. You know what I'm saying? Musically, you still haven't shown no growth. And I know you're popular right now. You know what I'm saying? And that's what's up. You know what I'm saying? Because honestly, you are the biggest artist from Philly right now, besides the Lil Uzis and the PMB Rock.
And both of them niggas. Fuck them.
God damn, yo.
I'm sorry, but fuck them niggas.
Yo. Yeah, man. But that's something else. But far as I was disappointed in the Meek album. I was probably feeling, I think, maybe 2 or 3 songs. Two or three at the most. And I'ma be honest. You know, people be like, oh damn, Meek show growth. He talking some good content. No, Meek sucks at trying to sound positive. I wanna hear Meek negative, yo. I'm just being real, yo. You know what I'm saying? Styles P, The Lox, Beanie Sigel, you know, they hardcore street rappers. Even Pusha T. But you know what makes them different? They have vocabulary. They have creativity on how they construct their songs. Me, you still yelling. Yeah, you wasn't yelling on some of the songs. But when you come off trying to be positive, talking some real shit, it doesn't sound sincere. That's just my opinion, yo. You know what I'm saying? I know y'all gonna root for the popularity guy. You know what I'm saying? Because that's just the era that we in. You know, it's not about music now. It's about popularity and who got swag and all that. Yeah. You know, that's just how it is. You know what I mean? And I'm always going to be considered, looked at as a, when it comes to music, as the hater. But I just love music. I listen to everything. I listen to everything from fucking Frank Sinatra to Old Dirty Bastard. You feel me?
That's
so
it.
It's not just hip hop with me. Like I really do this music thing and critique it and listen and I go hard for it. You know what I mean? But is any other albums, Kel, that was disappointing for you for 2017 so far?
Damn, there's a lot of shit that was disappointing. I believe Meek Mill's was number one. Right off the top, I can't think of nothing.
Fuck with the Drake, John.
Damn, man, why you put me in that predicament? Drake, I'm gonna tell you fans like this. Drake is an incredible artist, but far as hip hop, I don't see Drake in the hip hop arena. Drake is a pop artist to me. So far as pop, he's an incredible artist. But as for hip hop, I'm cool. You know what I'm saying? He don't rap enough for me. He's singing, he's reggaeing. He's doing everything else besides hip hop. I respect him as an artist, but he don't do enough hip hop for me. If Drake was to put out a strictly hip hop album, then I can treat him. What I'm trying to say, boy.
Could
there we go, bro. Contrict him.
Yo, that's some fucked rock. Up.
That's
shout
the,
out Puff, yo.
Shout out Puff. You know what I mean? That's rock. The Ciroc. I can, whatever. You don't know what the fuck I'm trying to say. I can do that on an album, but until he put out a strictly hip hop album, I can't contrict him on that. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Got you. Can't critique him.
Nigga, you know what I'm trying to say. Nigga, fuck that.
Yo, no, I feel you on that, yo. I think the only song I was feeling on the Drake joint was the, Fake Friends or some shit like that.
Now, hold up.
Is that the joint?
Hold up.
I don't know.
Pull it up now. Yeah,
pull that shit up, yo.
Now, hold up. Now, on the Drake album. Now, I was feeling a few joints. Now, the first song on the album is called,
Oh, that Portland John was banging. That's pretty cool.
Man.
I know, they gotta take you through all that shit. It's right there, More Life.
There we go, More Life. Free Smoke was dope. That's the first song on the album. Free Smoke was dope. I fuck with that.
Passion Fruit, you fuck with that?
Passion Fruit, I fuck with that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying, dude? I know y'all might think, I don't think these niggas fuck with that, but I fuck with that. Mm. You know what I mean? He just had 22 songs, man. In 2017, it's hard to go through
Fake Love.
20, you know what I'm saying, 22 songs. Fake Love was alright. I fuck with that. Glow was alright with Kanye West. I fuck with that. He had a few songs on here that I fuck with. Passion Fruit, I fuck with. But, a lot of that shit is like reggae.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Now, I know Canada has a strong influence on the Jamaica culture.
Yeah.
But God damn.
And then it's like,
God damn.
It ain't fucking believable that you fucking light skinned. And you fucking reggaeing. I gotta use my man Kel name reggaeing and shit. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean?
Hold up, yo. Now. You a light skinned nigga too now.
I ain't reggaeing.
What complexion got to do with the motherfucking?
I know, right?
With the motherfucking hip hop shit.
I
nigga.
Know, yeah. Yeah, you right.
Come on, man.
I like how you flipped that off. You right. I got out of my Vic bag. I might as well tell him to get a haircut and look professional. Like, you know, that's the way he get back in the game. It's like, no. But, yeah. Overall, I wasn't feeling Drake joint like that. Probably about 3 joints for me. It looks like about 4 joints for you.
For Drake joint.
And I'm going to tell y'all, I ain't even attempt to listen to Migos, John, so fuck all
fuck
that.
Fuck that.
I ain't listening to that bullshit. But I definitely, before we go into the next segment, as far as, because the next thing we're going to get into is we're going to name our top 5 rappers all time. But before we get into that, just more than recently, rest in peace to Sean Price. He released the album, and I like how Duck Down Records did it. They ain't releasing on Friday. If you peep, you see what they did? They did the old school way. They released this album on a Tuesday. And that was dope, because guess what? His shit number 1 on iTunes right now.
Get the fuck out of here. Man,
no fucking lie, yo.
Now,
no fucking lie.
Now.
Sean Price, new album, Imperial Rex. It's number 1 on iTunes. At least it was yesterday. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, that was smart.
Absolutely.
Released the shit on a Tuesday, the old school way, instead of fucking Friday. You know Friday is, you know, is everybody coming out on Friday.
Right, right.
So that's smart. The maneuver, the charts and shit like that. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
But fuck the little smart maneuvers and all that. That's a good album.
I agree, bro.
It's a good album, yo.
I love Sean Price, the way he spit. And not just because he recently passed away, but He just a dope fucking MC. I don't care what
hilarious,
y'all say.
Entertain you.
He got them punchlines. Oh, he got them bars and everything. The only thing that I disagree with the new album, Imperial Rex, is he put his wife on the album. Now, we don't know if he agreed with that.
I know, right?
Maybe he just was trying to shut the wife up. You know, happy wife, happy life.
Yeah.
Maybe he was just trying to shut her up.
Yeah.
And he didn't want that on the album, but Duck Down actually agreed to that. But, you know what I'm saying?
He might have agreed to it because, you know, he's dead. She get the executive credit. You know
right,
what I'm saying? Just so she can get paid.
Right.
They probably
right.
did it on the strength of that, which I'm all for that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But what was eerie was the song with the P's. I don't know if I'm saying rap kind of
hard. Prodigy and Styles P. Hard.
Sean Price. Prodigy and Styles P. Yeah. You said it, but you just didn't mention Sean Price.
Yeah.
All the P's, which is crazy, yo. Crazy. Yeah, we at the hour and 20 minute mark. This about to be the longest episode ever. You know what I'm saying? Podcast, you know what I'm saying?
Well, God bless Kel on that.
You know what I'm saying? Hood geniuses in the building.
We shout out to Lady T.
Yeah, always. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, this, you know, but this is how we do. Y'all more than welcome to sit down with the Hood Geniuses podcast. This is how we do. Lay back, chill people, throw back some drinks and have open conversation. Whatever happens, happens. We talk, we grown folks, you know, voice your opinion. That's the reason why the podcast was created, you know what I'm saying? But you said enough as far as with the Sean Price album?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So, all right, you want to go first as far as the name of your top five?
I know you said
you're going to do it.
I'll go first. I got Eras with my top five. So, early mid-80s, I'm going to start there. I was born in 77, so I'm going to go with the mid-80s. And my top five in the mid-80s is no particular order. Rakim, Big Daddy Kane, KRS-One, LL Cool J, Cool G Rap. Now, early 90s, late 90s, I'm going to go with Nas. No particular order, remember. Pac, J, Styles, P, Black Thought.
That's
five?
That's five.
Oh.
Probably
I gotta subtract somebody because Biggie didn't live long enough, but I gotta put Biggie in there for impact and what he brought to the culture. So I'm gonna take out Styles P and I'm gonna put in Biggie. Alright, so I'm gonna put Biggie, Black Thought, Jay-Z, Tupac, and Nas. Sorry, Styles P, one of my favorite rappers. Number six.
Damn.
What you got, Bill?
I like how you did it. Damn. That's very creative. Very creative. I like that. I'm going to just go straight top five.
Top five?
Yeah. You want me to do the errors?
Do what you got to do.
No, I'm going to do... Fuck it. It's gonna be tough. Number one, I'm putting mine in order.
Oh shit.
You know what I mean? Number one is Nas.
Woo!
Point blank.
Number one, Nas.
Damn.
Who number
this is
two,
tough,
nigga?
Yo. This is really tough. Number two.
Let's go.
Number two is Tupac.
Woo! My
name. You know what I'm saying? Number two is Tupac. I just, man, that dude, it ain't about the lyrical thing.
Oh, time out.
You know what I mean?
Time out. I'm sick of these young niggas. Am I loud enough? I'm sick of these young brothers saying that Tupac is not lyrical. Absolutely lyrical. Absolutely lyrical. So don't even, you don't even have to.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. You right. All right. Number three, I got to say Rakim. Yeah, Rakim. I mean, the flawless flow before, you know, his flow was before his time. He birthed Nas, to absolutely be honest with you.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? He birthed Nas, man, and this dude did it all without cussing. His flow, yes, and vocabulary was just done effortlessly. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely, I agree.
You know what I mean? Number four for me. Some may disagree, but number four, Jay-Z.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Jay-Z, yo.
Okay.
And then
Number five.
Woo. Taking time.
See, I left for MC out, but I want to see.
Number five, I gotta say, KRS-One.
Woo!
If you don't know about KRS-One catalog, you don't know hip hop. And ain't no way in the world for me to be who I am that I'ma leave KRS-One off my list, yo.
That's dope.
You know what I'm saying?
That's dope.
And I'ma tell you, y'all probably might, some might laugh at this, but LL Cool J almost made my top five.
Shit, who was you wanna leave off?
Big Daddy Kane. But then it's like,
oh, was Daddy Kane in your top five?
He almost made it, yo.
Who knocked him out?
Rakim. Yeah.
Damn. That's why I had to do two eras because.
Yeah. I like how you did it.
You know what I'm saying? Like the MCing was. It was so much different once it got to the 90s. Yeah. It was so many different elements. Incorporated into the MC, you know what I mean? So I had to do two eras, but you know, it is what it is, man. Daddy Kane got to be in my top five. You know what I'm saying? But woo, that's a good list, man. I can't complain with that, bro.
Yeah, man.
Can't complain. Can't complain.
Man. You see. Kel get me rolling, yo. When we talk this music and hip hop shit, yo. You know what I mean? I just wanna shout out everybody that continue to rock and support us. You know what I'm saying? I gotta shout out the good brothers of Unified Global. They holding us down. I gotta shout out Water Ice. I gotta shout out Ben Gotti. I gotta shout out
my name.
You know what I'm saying? I gotta shout out everybody. All the listeners, the followers, like our SoundCloud is, you know, still building. You know, we at almost 240 followers. That may not mean a lot to some, but we just started in November. And I probably really started the SoundCloud account maybe like March. You feel what I'm saying? Maybe like March or shit, maybe February. I don't even remember, but just the fact that this is only August and I got 240 followers, you know what I'm saying, on SoundCloud. Yo,
Just
shout out to everybody. Continue to listen, share, you know, do what you do. Follow us on Instagram at Hood Geniuses Pod on everything. You know, and I want to thank Mikel, my bro, for doing this episode with me. Y'all gonna hear his name a lot more. I know, see, what y'all don't know is the Hood Geniuses Podcast, we got a lot of members that just be playing the background. You hear their name here and there, you know what I'm saying? But Mikal is not only a supporter, he's in the background. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gotta tell you the things he do. You know what I'm saying? But y'all gonna see. We got big things coming, yo. You know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna end the episodes like I always end them. Dream hard and don't sleep forever. Thank you. Peace.
You are now an official hood genius. Thanks for listening. Make sure you subscribe and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Y'all know what to do.
Hit that follow button.